I'm Wenda Royster. You're listening to the Wenda Royster Show right here on 1010 WOLB. And we're talking with Minister Lenita Reeves, and she's just a wealth of knowledge. Minister Reeves, welcome back.
Thank you so much, Wenda. Great to be with you.
Well, tell me all about your book that you're writing.
Well, I'm writing a book that is very dear and near to my heart. The title of the book is called The Journey from Rape to Redemption.
Mm-hmm.
And it takes a look at the biblical account of Jacob's only daughter, Dinah.
Mm-hmm.
And we see in Genesis that it describes the events that surrounded her rape. And rape is not something that we talk about very openly in the body of Christ,
mm-hmm.
but it is something that we cannot deny that is affecting our women and, listen to this, Wenda, our men, because
mm-hmm.
men are rape victims as well.
That's right.
And so this work, this project is something that I have cried about, that I have lived, and then I've seen the power of God in my own life. And I wrote this book for every person that is has been a victim of rape, but not only for rape victims. We know that one out of every six women are victims of an attempted or a completed rape in their lifetime. One out of six.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
So one out of every six women.
Mm-hmm.
And so the book is not only for those that have been affected personally by rape, but it is for people who have a loved one who has been a victim of rape. And it will help even those to be a support mm-hmm. and a loving source of counsel and comfort.
Well, I'm so glad to hear about this book because it's something that needs to be talked about. There's healing. You know, when you look at it's the serious crime of rape that's mm-hmm. being committed in the whole community, but especially in the African American community.
Mm-hmm.
History shows us so many times it's been overlooked.
Yes.
There are many, many women that are living today
mm-hmm.
who have been raped
mm-hmm.
and were told to keep quiet.
That's right.
There are women who have been raped by relatives
mm-hmm.
and you know, I know that pain has to be long-standing in their lives.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it just brings up in me such a feel of
mm-hmm.
of just how we, I'm so glad you're writing it, because we have to really talk about this.
Mm-hmm.
And so many times I've heard people say, well, it's not a murder, but, you know, it's destroying someone's life.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think it's very ironic that you use the word fuel,
mm-hmm.
because I'll read you a part of the introduction from the book,
mm-hmm.
and there's a connection to that word fuel. It says, as a rape survivor and Christian female minister, the biblical account of Dinah's rape was, for a long time, one of the hardest passages of Scripture for me to digest and understand. Once you have experienced the pain of rape, hearing the story of someone else's violation lights a fire of indignation within you. The flame is even greater when it is a biblical account that evokes questions about the love of God.
Mm.
And so when you use that word fuel, there's a connection there,
mm-hmm.
because if you've experienced rape, it does do something in you to hear about somebody else being violated,
mm-hmm.
and I use the word violate very strategically because rape is a violation.
Yes.
And I want in this book and through the pages of this book, I want to expose that it is a violation, but also that there is healing, that there is deliverance, and there is redemption.